diving back in so we don't run over too heavily. So I'm gonna pass the mic down here because our judges will be doing something. So we are going to be calling a few names. Before I start, can I get one final cheer for all your contestants here in the top six? So, can Slutdrop Sally and Steely Man please come to the stage now? Thank you very much. This is a tough job to do, but unfortunately you two are our bottom two contestants this week. So we're gonna go to the judges for some critique to give you some time to change afterwards for the lip sync performance tonight. So we'll start with Amphetamine.
Hello, hello, hi angels. I just want to start off by saying no one was bad tonight.
Yes,
no
yes.
One was bad at all. Can we give a cheer for everyone again, please? Was bad. We were literally picking at little tiny things here because everyone was fucking incredible. I will start with you, Slutdrop. You know how much, like, I love everyone in this competition. I would say that I do respect everyone in this competition, I respect those performers, and I love them so much. Just when you were on stage, it did seem a little bit like you were discombobulated a wee bit. You tried so, like, I could see that you wanted to do a fierce performance, but you just seemed a little kind of like, right, I need to do this. But it just seemed out of turn with everyone else. And I would say that would probably be the same with yourself as well, Stelia. Like, it wasn't in sync with each other. It just kind of seemed all off. For your runways, I love both of the messages. The messages are absolutely fucking incredible, and I love both of them so much. I would just say my personal thing is the execution of it. For me, Slutdrop is, I would not have put the blood right on the middle of the stage. It just, as a professional thing, someone can come and slip on that, and you fuck up someone else. And it's just, I wouldn't have done that. I would just be a bit more wary about what you're doing with your gags and be wary of everyone else in the competition. I know it's like, oh, sabotage and all the rest of it, but just be a bit wary. Stelia, you know, obviously this is a message that speaks to my heart. Trans women to trans women, we are fucking trans sisters and we speak so fucking much about this. You know that I love you from the bottom of my heart and I've loved you for many years and we've had many conversations and I would absolutely class you as one of my close friends. I love you so fucking much. I do wish the execution was just a little better. That's my personal opinion. I do wish it was just a tiny, tiny bit better. I think the leotard was just a little not correct and like the fitting of like the, what do you call it? The leg holes. But you know how much I love you. I love both of you so fucking much. And I just want to congratulate you. You did do an amazing job. I am literally just picking at like little tiny things here. I love both of you so much. I'll pass you on to Blaze.
Yes, now Blaze, yes. Also in the meantime, if anyone at the bar can hear me, you can get some blue roll so we can wipe up the floor. Thank you so much. I'll do it myself. No problem. Blaze.
Hi, my darlings. First of all, both of you, just incredible. Like, that's what I want to say first and foremost. We're here to have fun, and you both fucking killed it. But what I will say, Slutdrop. So what I wrote down here was all. So I noticed during that first number that you, when you stood here right in front of me, you were fucking serving. You were giving it a life and I was living for it. However, when you were in the back, there was nothing in the face. But I just want you to remember you're always on stage. Maybe you're not at the front, even if you're at the back, you're still on the stage. And that's what I wrote down because I feel like whether you're in the back or the front, you have to live your fucking fantasy. Now with the runway, super creative. I'd be lying if I say that I could even do something similar. Like, you're so creative and I love that about you, but what I will say is that I just felt like it just wasn't as, it came down to this, it wasn't as strong as a few of the other girls. And the thing is I also didn't really tie in the blood with the global warming. If it was fire and earth, camp. Well, not camp, fuck. Okay, no camp. But you get what I'm saying. But how old did you say you were, Madonna? 18. So before I move on. I mean, That's incredible. And I'll tell you what, I'm 28 now. I do not want to be in a drag competition with you at 28. Put it that way. Still young. So, again, I will say, just not as strong as other girls, but when it comes to the performance, first and foremost, I will say that I was watching you the whole time. I loved it. However, I could see in your face that you didn't know what bit was next. Now, I understand it's a lot of choreography, and you mean, do you count yourself as a dancer? Here and there. What I would say is I could see in your face what was coming next. You were concerned about, when am I picking this up? When am I standing to the left? When am I going to the right? And you have to believe in yourself a bit more, because you're fucking sickening. At parks, I was like, this bitch doesn't know she's sickening. So that's the one thing I would work on, it's just confidence, because you're worth it, bitch. But, and the runway, again, I would just echo what the girl said. I absolutely love it. I obviously love the message. I'm trying to separate the message from the look. We're here to judge the look, and I absolutely love the message, but it is a bit of a leotard with the blood. We saw the blood before. Listen, you look sickening, but just not as strong as other girls. Over to League of Rampant.
Yes. So, yeah. It's political queen, Lady Rampant!
Hello! Alright, okay, I'm going to say really now. I am literally going to echo what these two queens said. I find this very hard because I actually see myself in both of you so much. And I'm not just saying that, I really, really do. So I'm going to start with you, Slipknot Sally, darling. I would say in the dance challenge, I thought you were great. You were very clearly, I don't know if you and Lisa are dancers, you were very clearly the dancer of the group, but when you were in the back, I was like, don't give us a smile, come on. Like, give me a smile. But when you're focused on choreography, maybe that's not the first thing. So that's all I would say, just beware of your other group members. But I still thought your dancer was great. I mean, you can dance better than me, doll, so that seems something. Your reading challenge, have you ever read anybody before? Big round of applause for reading for the first time! And it's so difficult to stand at the mic and make fun of people that you like. I thought you went for it. I thought you gave it your all. I thought you did so well. And it might not have been the funniest, but do you know what? You went for it, John, so congratulations. As for your runway, I mean, I love this. Like, it very much connects me. When I said I had 3 points, my first one was clarity. This was clear straight away. I thought I was doing climate change. But for me, the second point, the message wasn't strong enough with the bloody stuff. I didn't get it. I don't really know what I'm trying to do different, and that's not a good critique. But see the red tool. What's the red? Is it blood? What is it?
I had an original plan where I was
going
to have this in here and rip this to shreds, but just paper mache didn't set in time.
Do you know what I think would have been better? See a sexier protest sign, and then you come there, and then you turn the sign, and then we all gang. That would have maybe been better because we'd have got the message, the clear message. We all knew you were doing climate change, so it's not a read on your message, it's just more like the very, very fine details. I thought you were great. Big round of applause for Slipknot Sally! Thank you so much, darling. I'm Celia, man. I'm going to ask you this question, darling. Are you a dancer? Honey, neither am I. But do you know what I thought? See, when you started, you were fucking gone for it. You were absolutely gone for it. Come on, I'm not a dancer either, but you were standing right there and I can see how much you were going for it. So I want to commend you for that. Maybe the group overall wasn't as cohesive, but I thought you were absolutely going for it. As for your reads, as for the mic, I think that comes with a little bit of more experience of holding the mic to your mouth so that your voice is very loud, because I missed some of your punchlines because you were doing it. So which is funny, but you're doing it. So I would say in future, if you're doing a read, if you're on the mic, all you need to do is hold it closer, and it is like literally picking hairs at this point. It's just so that every joke lands. As for your message, I have absolutely nothing to say on it. It may be a bodysuit, but the message in itself speaks in itself. So, everyone, big round of applause for Sienna!
Right, so we are going to let the two of you get dressed for the lip sync. Thank you so much. We are closer. We can run on. We will not be eagerly.